It's being called a humanitarian crisis at the U.S.-Mexico border. Thousands of kids alone, scared, separated from their families. Many have been placed in facilities and homes across the country.
Well, the Biden administration says it's working to reunite them with their parents. But for many, it is a long and painful journey. A little boy, though, is doing his part to help by writing the president. Here's Jackie Orozco.
The first time she met me, she was really nice. Mm-hmm. Gavin was like,
Seven-year-old Jack McCarsky is quite the kid with plenty of personality.
I wanted to write the letter, but it took like 9 days.
Pouring it all out in a letter to the president.
Dear President Biden, my name is Jack. I'm 7 years old. Please call me by my full name, Jack Joseph Gonzalez McCarsky. I wanted to tell you about my new brother and sister.
About 14-year-old Kevin and 10-year-old Genesis.
Their mom couldn't cross the border.
Andy and Jim McCarsky have been fostering the siblings.
They left Honduras when their father was murdered.
We're concealing their identity for safety, but sharing their emotional story.
And so we got a phone call from one of our church members from First UU of Columbus. And they were like, hey, do you know anybody who would help to support some unaccompanied minors that are here in Columbus?
For 2 years, their biological mother has been waiting for her asylum case to be heard with hopes of reuniting with her kids in the U.S.
Mom chose to stay in the camp and not come over illegally.
Her asylum case denied twice already.
Like any other mom, just wants the best for her children. She had to make the hardest decision. I don't know that I could have made it to send her children unaccompanied across the border.
The McCarskys, already parents of four adopted kids, decided they needed to open their home and hearts once again.
We kind of decided to do a little family meeting and talk to the kids and say, hey, you want to make some room for more? They're all like, sure.
I didn't know what they looked like, so it's like, I thought they were like really, really good. Like really good looking.
But there's a bit of a language barrier with the new siblings.
Did you understand them? Did they speak English or no?
They didn't, but Tennessee's learned really fast. Uh-huh. Really fast.
Do you know any Spanish words?
Yeah. Si means yes. But I taught her gatos means cat, but I taught her gatos cat, gatos cat.
But one language that everyone can understand, their love for each other. From playing.
Usually play Minecraft.
To having family outings.
Also, they love Chinese food.
Just like any typical American family, without any worries of kidnappings or violence. Then.
It's okay.
This happened just a few months ago.
She crossed the border and it was just kind of overnight. She landed in Texas and then, you know, shortly thereafter came to see the kids.
Embracing their biological mom. For the first time after being apart for nearly a year.
It's probably one of the most special things I've ever witnessed.
That's why little Jack wanted to write this very important letter to a very important person.
Thank you for letting their mom cross the border. I am sad and happy that they're going to be with their mom soon. I think you are doing a great job. Your friend, Jack Joseph Gonzalez Wachowski. That's the end of the whole thing. That's a very short letter.
A short letter, but with a powerful message.
Thousands of people are. And a lot of kids are in jail.
From this 7-year-old boy. And the letter wouldn't be complete.
It's Godzilla.
Without some of his talented artwork.
There's happy eyes, yep.
Also mailing a drawing of the White House and.
And Godzilla.
Kevin and Genesis are still in Columbus until the end of the school year, but they'll be moving in with their mom in Texas permanently, leaving behind a sad but happy Clintonville family as they're finally reunited with their mother. In the studio, Jackie Orozco, ABC 6 News.
Due in no small part to Jack Joseph Gonzani Mocharski.
Oh,
love that
guy. Just fantastic.
Great job, young man.
Yes, wonderful to see the family story.
Oh,
All right, check this out. An emotional reunion nearly a year in the making. Two young kids who'd been living with a foster family here in Columbus finally reunited with their mother, that mom seeking asylum in America from Honduras. Now, we've been following the family's fight to call America home for months now. Jackie Orozco with the heartwarming update that you will only see right here on ABC 6.
Fourteen-year-old Kevin mixed with emotions, saying he's happy knowing he'll be with his mom soon, but sad because he's leaving his new Clintonville family behind.
Watching a mom being separated from their kids and me being able to just stand in and provide that love and care has been rewarding and fulfilling.
The McCarskies have been fostering Kevin and his 10-year-old sister Genesis for more than 6 months now. Their mom, Cedia, stuck in Houston, fighting for her asylum case, fighting to call the U.S. home for good.
Es un tiempo muy difícil.
She says the last 2 years has been hard, to say the least, opening up about her painful story of perseverance and survival, escaping the violence in her native home, Honduras, her husband killed, and her kids nearly kidnapped, taking a potentially deadly risk, traveling thousands of miles for a better life.
Dios puso en medio de ese proceso, Dios puso gente muy buena en nuestro camino.
She says God put good people in her path, like the McCarsky family.
It's a whirlwind, and everything is so different from when the day they came.
Since Thanksgiving, Kevin and Genesis have been living in Ohio, making new brothers and sisters, and seeing snow for the first time.
Cuando vine aquí fue la primera vez que vi la nieve.
While their mom recently crossed the border legally, her immigration case is still in limbo. That's why 7-year-old Jack McCarsky wrote a letter to the president hoping to help.
Dear President Biden,
Kevin's message to the McCarskies. He says he's thankful for all of their help. The family helped Kevin and Genesis finish school for the year, trying to live a normal life.
She just got an award at school when she left for being the most kind and helpful in her class. That's exactly how I would describe her, kind and generous and helpful, and I like to describe her as sparkly. She just lights up a room.
That's why it's so hard to say goodbye.
She wants a cake.
The church family throwing this farewell party.
Be sure to double check before the TSA checkpoint.
We were there as they got ready to board a flight to Houston to finally reunite with mom.
This is the first flight.
Dad getting them ready.
Here in Columbus.
And not without one last hug from a family who've done so much to help.
I love you so much. Be strong, okay?
And despite the language and culture barrier,
I love you.
Jack's in the middle.
Be safe, okay? You guys be safe?
They say they'll always be a family.
They're mine. Always will be mine. So I'm going to miss them desperately.
Hours and a plane change later. The moment they've been waiting for. Tears of joy as they embraced mom in Houston for the first time in what seems like a lifetime. Tears also miles away in Columbus.
It's bittersweet. We're so happy that they get to go be with their mom.
The family of 8, now back to a family of 6.
It's not a goodbye. It's an until then.
Now Kevin and Genesis can call Columbus, Ohio their second home, because family is everything.
The McCarskies hoping their story will inspire others to help all the other Kevins and Genesis out there, adding that as Americans, we can be gracious hosts and remember that these are children who need to be loved. On your side in the studio, Jackie Orozco, ABC 6 News.